Welcome to today's little vlog. In today's video, we are showing you what Kangaroo Island looks like. Now, Kangaroo Island is an island off the shore of Australia. Depending where you are in Australia, depends on obviously how long it takes to get there. But if you heard about it in late 2019 to early 2020, you would have heard about the Kangaroo Island bushfires. Now, later on in the video, we do go through some of the areas that were burned, but for now I'm just showing you some of the scenery and some of the areas that were burned and weren't burned. So as you can see, we have a beautiful top view of what most of Kangaroo Island looks like. It is honestly a beautiful island. I had never been before. This was my first time ever going, and I was honestly blown away at just how beautiful it was. Not only was it beautiful, it was just so freeing and relaxing, and it was so cold while doing this trek because we went up a, like a little mountain for this part, but it was so worth it. I had never done so much exercise other than going from at the very bottom, you see those like white strips, you had to run all the way up to get to the very top so you could see the beautiful view. So that was part of the trek we went up. These are just some seagulls, but they look so cute. Now this was a local market that we went to. They were selling all different things. This here is the bee farm. We went to a place that sells fresh honey. As you can see, these are the bees working on them. Some more seagulls because we went to some beaches, and of course seagulls will always be there. Now look how beautiful this beach is. Oh my god. If you don't like feet, I apologize for some of the clips. I tend to take videos of my feet in some parts, I don't know why. As you can see here, this is a poisonous snake. I don't remember what snake, but I just remember when we were doing the minor tour that he said not to go near it or touch it because it will kill me. That's a kangaroo, in case you weren't aware. And no, actual Australians do not ride them. We just say that to give Americans shit. As you can tell, I have a huge passion for nature and just the environment in general when it comes to my photography and videographing, so I tend to do that a lot. And there's just so many beautiful things that I wanted to capture as much as possible. So you will see a lot of up close and far away video shots. Now over here you can see the beautiful ocean. Don't ask me what ocean that is, I couldn't tell you. But yeah, I just like taking videos of different landscapes and showing you all the beautiful things that Kangaroo Island has to offer. Now obviously when COVID is not a huge thing, or you know, when you are able to fly, obviously wait a little bit for everything to calm down, but I would 100% recommend Kangaroo Island as a place to visit, to relax. Honestly, a honeymoon here would be great. It is beautiful. Now we're going to have a bit of a montage slash lots of videos of seals, because They are the cutest thing on the planet. Oh my god, I've never related more to an animal in my entire life until now. Who just doesn't want to have snuggles? Who is touch starved? Let me know. We got to go up close and personal to them, obviously with a little bit of distance to respect their boundaries, as well as we were told not to get too close because they can hurt us and we do not want that. Now, I do have to say, this was definitely one of the highlights of my trip when I went to Kangaroo Island. Just seeing them all move around and be in their natural habitat, as well as having the tour guide that we had. He was absolutely amazing. He gave us so much detail on the seals and how happy they are and what they do to make sure that they're good, as well as keeping a really good relationship between humans and the seals. It was just really cool to see and kind of, you know, hear about, and in a little while you'll see them fight. It's playful fighting, of course, but you'll see that. You'll see slash hear their cries trying to talk to each other. It's just beautiful. Now, just to let you know, they're not like 100% fighting. It's more like two brothers having a play fight, or, you know, just friends kind of mucking around, so they aren't hurting each other, but, you know, they are having fun. And you can see just before there, he put like his little paw on or flipper, just been like, yeah bro, you're all good, all right cool, we'll keep going. The other one just gave up, but, you know, now they're just gonna continue to play fight. And I think we have a winner, ladies and gentlemen and non-binary people. I just have to say, there were tons and tons of seals. It spanned the entire beach length. They were just all lying there in the sun, just taking in the sun's rays. It was a beautiful day. It was perfect weather, sun was out, wasn't too hot, it was just right, and it was absolute paradise for them. As you can tell, there's some slight different colors and things like that. Most of them are the same. There are some that are not of the same like type of seals, but they all get along. Another fun fact, seals tend to roll around in the sand to kind of help them cool down. So that's why some of them are more sandy than others. It really depends. But they tend to do that just to kind of keep some cold, which I thought was a really cool fact to learn. Now, as you can see here, we have a mother or father bringing in their child. They probably had just come back from a long trek. Yep, that's them doing their cries there. They probably had just come back from a long trek, either going out fishing for a couple of days or just showing the youngling what to do. So it really depends on what they were doing, but as you can see, they're kind of all waddling away. Now in this one, you're going to hear a mother cry for its child and them reuniting. Again, this is the most wholesome thing on the planet. Alright, I'll be quiet now. first they weren't entirely sure if they were the correct mother and child, but once realizing, you can see the mum has moved over, trying to give the kid a bit of room to kind of nuzzle on the mum, and it's just the most wholesome thing on the planet. Like, come on. It was so cute. Now, the entire island is not very big itself. You could probably travel the entire island from one side to the other in just under 2 hours, which is not very big, but you know, going at proper speed, you could probably get around the whole island within the day. So as you can see in this, there's a lot of like darker areas. This is where, unfortunately, one of the bushfires on Kangaroo Island hit the most. So as you can see in this clip here, there is a lot of new growth coming through, but a lot of obviously areas that are still burned. So they are still obviously trying to bring back the environment as much as possible. So this was at an abandoned lighthouse that we found that was kind of on the trek. But as you can just see, it was completely burned. Most of the nature was burned. There was none of the buildings were touched, thankfully, but a lot of the nature was destroyed, which was really sad to see. More seals! Who doesn't love more seals? As someone who'd never been to Kangaroo Island, I really thought there would be, like, honestly, so many kangaroos. But there hardly isn't really any. Like, there were lots, don't get me wrong, but I feel like there were almost more seals than there were kangaroos, which was kind of weird for me, but I thought it was kind of cool. So as you can see in this really shaky clip, oh my god, I'm so sorry. there's, like, two other islands not far away. I'm not sure what they're called, but they were in reach. And this area here, it was not far away, but you had to take like this, again, long walk, as everything is a long walk. You kind of went down this bridge and you could see all of the seals just kind of, you know, swimming around and being in the water or lying on the rocks, depending on what they felt like. And again, this is just one of those things where it was so cool to see them kind of be in their natural habitat and be extremely happy and honestly really chill around all the humans. Like, they honestly were just hanging out. None of us were close enough to touch them because obviously we wanted to make sure that we are far away enough where they don't hurt us, but also we don't hurt them. But you know, this was close enough where, obviously, as you can see here, I can get some pretty close videos or photos. I did take some photos, but you know, I'm close enough, as you can see there, where I can get pretty good photos or videos, but far away enough where I'm not getting hurt or they're not either, which is a pretty cool thing to see. And then obviously there's just some nature stuff here and there. I really wanted to try and put in a mix because we're now doing this voiceover. I realize that like probably over 50% of this video is just seals. And I'm not sorry about it, to be honest. For example, I don't know if this counts for everyone or not, but I'm a person who really loves to just watch things. I really love watching people in their own quote-unquote natural habitat. I love watching things without them noticing. So being able to just literally stand there for like an hour or two and just watch them kind of move and do their own thing without obviously any distractions and them just kind of living their lives was such a cool experience because, you know, you got to see them play, you got to see them eat, you got to see them hang out. Like, solely the only reason that I left this place was because A, my battery had ran flat on my camera. I brought two batteries, they both went flat, and my SIM card was full. And the people I was with wanted to leave, which was kind of sad, but you know, they were my transport, so I didn't want to get left behind that much. But I mean, other than that, I enjoyed it so much and I am super excited to go back again. I'm definitely making it on my list to go back to when everything is safe and sound. Again, if you also can't tell, I have a huge obsession with water, especially the just any type of, sorry, I hit the microphone. I have a obsession with water of any type, so especially just watching it move. It's one of those things where to me it reminds me of chaos, but in the most beautiful way possible. Because you look at an ocean, right? It looks beautiful, serene, quiet and calm. But if you look at it from another light, it can look chaotic and messy and terrifying. But it can also be the most beautiful thing on the planet. It's all how you look at it, you know? To me, it is a sea of wonder. But to another person, it's terrifying because it's a giant unknown. And I think that's one of the cool things about the ocean and water itself. You never know what it's going to do, whether it's a good thing or bad thing, because it is just one giant chaotic mess. So in this clip here, we're looking at another lighthouse because there are a lot of lighthouses. Lighthouses. This one had stopped being in use, but as you can tell, they obviously keep it updated. They try and refresh it. They try to make sure they look after it, which I think is super cool. Even though they don't really use it, you know, they still make sure that the quote unquote paintwork looks good, or like, you know, everything's well looked after. Now this was just a giant ass rock that we decided to climb up. I don't know why, but I'm so glad we did. We literally just bolted up. Apparently most people do this, as you can see in the clip as well. All of that area was all very severely burnt by the fires. But back to the giant rock. We got to climb up top of this rock and just kind of look around and just see everything. You could see most of the areas where the island got burned. And then you could just see the beautiful ocean, and then back to like this oranginess that was on the rock, which I'm not really sure why it was on the rocks, but it was just, you know, on there. You know, you could climb all through it. There were so many different cavities and holes and just weird places. It was really cool. Now obviously you can see here, all of this was beautiful, green, lush nature that just got burned, unfortunately, due to the fires. But you know, it's obviously being taken care of, and I don't know if I took a video or not, but they did have signs all over being like, please stay off the grass, or please stay off the nature, we're trying to recover from the fires. So obviously the council there slash, you know, people of Kangaroo Island are really wanting to look after the island and really wanting to bring it back to its beautiful natural state. And honestly, I don't blame them. You know, it's such a beautiful island. I hope everyone goes back, and if you do, please support all the local businesses, because obviously they're bringing themselves back up to light. All of the businesses were super sweet that we went to. They're all so kind and lovely, and they will tell you any stories you want to hear. It was so worth it. So as you can see here, there's just so much of it burnt, which was really sad to see, but it was an amazing experience. And that was a rock we climbed up, just an FYI, so you know. It was pretty cool to see from like a distance, like, hey, we climbed that. But also here we are on the road where we can see more of the burned nature, which again, it's not fun. Overall, I rate this island, I don't know why I'm rating it, but I'm rating it like a 9 out of 10. I don't know, I feel like that's a pretty good number. My only reason it's not like 10 out of 10 is because, I don't know, I guess I have to go back one more time to see. I don't like to judge something based off of one experience, so I think I'll need to go back one more time and see what it was like, because damn, it was beautiful. Like, oh my god, I cannot stress enough just how beautiful it was. And the place we stayed at, which was like an Airbnb, was so comfortable, super big, and just like it felt really homely, which I really loved. The people were amazing. Like, we did so many cool activities there. If you're a person who drinks in the alcohol sense, they have plenty of like wine tasting, cider tasting, all that stuff. I personally don't drink, so I didn't do any of that, but the people I was with did it. So, you know, you have that as an option. And I'll probably should preface, if you are to go to the island and you do hit a kangaroo, which is a high chance you possibly could, it is okay if you do. Just make sure that you yourself are okay in the car and that you're able to keep driving. Fun fact, on Kangaroo Island, kangaroos are actually a pest. Not like they're trying to get rid of them, but they have too many of them. So if you do hit a kangaroo, don't feel as bad. Here is just some beautiful nature shots as well, because simplicity can be the best. And I really enjoyed it. And I hope you all enjoyed this little vlog of Kangaroo Island. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you soon.